Construction workers are known to work long hours and tend to be severely underappreciated. It's a thankless job, but a necessary one, and it would do most of us some good to tip our hats to these hardworking men and women every once in a while. However, for some people, their world simply revolves around themselves. Recently, a construction worker who goes by the name of Barbecue Lunch posted on Reddit an experience he had with a very rude woman and how he got revenge in the very best possible way. You won't believe this story. The construction worker posted that he was working as the foreman on a new housing project, and the location was quite odd because the house was 250 feet up a hill with access via a footpath only. This created a lot of work for the construction crew, since all their equipment had to be brought up by hand. Thankfully, one of the saving graces of this inconvenient situation was there were two parking spots at the bottom of the hill with no parking signs. This would allow deliveries and materials to be brought up the hill easier. Unfortunately, there was one small problem. There's an elementary school about a half block away, and the parents of children seem to regularly, at least twice a day, think it's okay to park in our spots, the construction worker posted. Now, I consider myself a reasonable person, so if someone's parked in the spots and we don't have a delivery or need to park a truck, I'll let it go. If we need the spot and there's someone parked there, however, I will ask them to move nicely, and most of the time they do so immediately. Until now. On the day of the job, the construction worker received a call from his lumber delivery truck that was on its way to the building site. He mentioned he'd be arriving in roughly 3 minutes, so the worker quickly made his way down the hill to make sure there was a place to park. Posting on Reddit, he explained, he was carrying all the material to frame the roof of our house, which is a lot of really big lumber and will take easily an hour to bring up the hill. So naturally, I didn't want him parked in the middle of the street with his hazards on for an hour when we have a perfectly good parking spot for him. As the worker approached the bottom of the hill, he noticed a school parent was sitting in her car in one of the spaces. Assuming she was waiting to pick up her kid, he walked up to the vehicle and politely made her aware that she was parked in a no parking zone. To say the worker was shocked by her response would be an understatement. Refusing to move, she said, "I'll just be a few minutes, and your truck isn't here. Take a chill pill, dude." We're thinking it's not the construction worker who needs to take the chill pill. Before the construction worker could answer, the lumber delivery truck pulled up to the job site. He motioned to the truck driver and then to the woman who was parked, gesturing that she refused to move. What could the worker do to solve the problem? Trying to win the rude driver over with a smile, the worker asked the woman if she would please move and that his delivery had just arrived. He reiterated that she was in a tow-away zone and they needed the parking space. Her response was surprising and infuriating. With a fake smile, the woman rolled down the window and suggested they unload the truck and work around her car. The worker was dumbfounded and couldn't believe she would suggest such a thing. Then he had an idea. It was time to plot his revenge. The worker quickly instructed the truck driver to park as close to the woman's car as possible, essentially blocking her in with the porta potty that was in an adjacent spot. The truck driver immediately realized what the worker wanted to do and, with a mischievous grin, maneuvered the truck to create a small parking spot prison cell for the woman. The construction workers began to unload the lumber while the foreman called the police to let the parking enforcement know they had a clear violation. At the time, the woman illegally parked seemed oblivious to her current situation. At this point in time, I wasn't trying to get her in trouble, I just wanted a record of why we were blocking part of the street so we don't get in trouble with the city. Thankfully, the parking officer let him know she could be at the job site in less than 30 minutes to deal with the situation. Around this time, the child of the woman who was parked in the space arrived, and she soon realized she couldn't get out of her driver's side door. Clambering over the center console, she awkwardly made her way out the passenger door, shooting death stares at the poor construction worker and delivery driver. Of course, the situation was only going to get worse. The woman soon realized that she had no way of getting out of the parking spot and couldn't leave. This, of course, sent her into a fit of rage. She demanded that the truck driver move because she was in a hurry and had someplace to be. Unfortunately for her, that simply wasn't going to happen. At this point, the truck driver intervened, explained to the woman that there were rules that needed to be followed. "Ma'am, in order to unload the lumber on the truck, we had to unstrap it, and per our company policy, I'm not allowed to move the truck with an unsecured load on it. Sorry," he informed her. Triggered by the truck driver, the woman flew into a rage and jumped back into her vehicle. At this point, the construction worker noticed the police officer had arrived but chose not to alert the woman, who was now preparing to make a very bad decision. She slammed the car into reverse, knocking over the porta potty, and then drove up onto the curb in an attempt to maneuver out of the space and around the lumber truck. Of course, this didn't work, and the car got stuck. Screaming obscenities at the top of her lungs, the woman struggled to back the car off the curb. At this time, a shocked police officer walked up to the vehicle and demanded the woman out and told her to sit on the curb. The officer called in for a second unit, to help contain the irate woman and slapped her in handcuffs. It seemed justice was about to be served. In the end, the construction worker would have the last laugh. The woman was arrested and charged with child endangerment, reckless driving, destruction of